President, what about the House vote that would require you to keep abiding by the SALT limits?
I tell you, we've got four wave groups coming in here, so I'm not going to take any.
I've got three other questions. President, is Mexico still angry with the United States over that congressional testimony about drug corruption last May?
I already said we.
There is another matter right now. We'll talk. Mr. Reagan, myself.
This way, please. Thank you. This way, please.
I am present.
Mr. President, another question. You two have got to stop meeting like this in about 2 years. What do you hope to accomplish at the end of all your meetings for all these years?
Well, now, as I said, we're not going to take any questions in here, but we're both well aware that there's a limitation on how much time we have left.
You'd like to change that, though?
No, not for me, for future presidents.
Will both of you leave office with stronger economies?
That's a great
question. Ask me questions.
I'm honored to
request.
This way,
please.
Yeah, maybe.
I cannot do this. We're not taking any questions, and we're just going to get into our meetings here.
Al final haremos una declaración.
Answer this question. I think it's going to leave you. President has been telling me here of your economic plans, of which we very much approve, and the things that you're doing. I touched on the subject of, just before we came in, it was very close to my heart and what I wanted to bring up, and that is my belief that no country has ever been economically successful without importing people and money. And we've spoken once before on this, and glad to hear what you were suggesting and doing. The very basis, I think, of development depends on encouraging not only your own capital to stay and be invested at home, but then import capital. And I know there have been some feelings in the past that, well, isn't this a way of then profits being exported to the foreign investor to attract his country instead of there, but the profits are so minor compared to the economy that is generated through employing your people, the payroll and buying supplies and so forth in your own country. And I know that you have had a very low percentage of outside investment. And I think I know that this may sound like interfering with in our own country, you might be interested in some of our total investment, about 24.5% is foreign. That's a
24 veces más que la inversión extranjera en México.
This meeting, I know, we have more subjects than just that. I hope we'll have time to
I tell you.
seat on this end. Family dining room. There's contrast with the state dining room out there for the big days. And then over the years, somebody let this just become a kind of a semi-storeroom and butler's pantry or something. And Nancy discovered it. And it is a nice room, and the paintings that were there and everything just closed off. And she restored it. And we have found that it's much more comfortable to be able to gather with this kind in here than out there in the middle of that big room wrapping around. So this was one of her chores that she completed. The revolution against cement was engaged in by working with the majority of people. They were rocking. One of the jokes.